एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इंटीग्रेटिंग डिफरेंशिएटिंग एंड क्लैंपिंग सर्किट ट्रेनर किट एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 36155। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाउ इट वर्क्स। सो दिस इज द इंटीग्रेटिंग डिफरेंशिएटिंग एंड क्लैंपिंग सर्किट ट्रेनर। दिस इज द वेरिएबल पावर सप्लाई ब्लॉक। हियर वी कैन वेरी द वोल्टेज फ्रॉम 0 टू 10 वोल्ट बाय यूजिंग दिस पॉट। Then this is the square wave oscillator block. Here we can generate square wave of 1 kHz and 10 kHz frequency. This is the ground port and we can use this switch to select the frequency of square wave. That is, if we want to use 1 kHz, you can press this switch, and if you want to use 10 kHz, you can again change this switch position. Then this is the diode, this is the resistance, this is another resistance, this is the capacitor, and this is the port which is provided to select the capacitor range from 470 pf to 1 microfarad. Now let's see the working of this kit. So we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study integrating circuit, differentiating circuit and clamping circuit. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the square wave oscillator to the capacitor, then we will connect the other terminal of capacitor to the resistance. Let's take the resistance 1k, then we will connect the other end of the 1k resistance to the ground of square wave oscillator. So that is how the connection is done. So firstly we will keep this capacitor port at 470 pf. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit and we will switch on the DSO. So after the connection is done, now we will observe the waveform. So firstly we will observe the square wave. So here you can see that on the DSO, this is the square wave and you can see the frequency also. So here we have selected 1 kHz. You can take 10 kHz also and 1 kHz. So first let's see the output waveform at 1 kHz input square wave. So we will see the output at 1 kilo ohm resistance. So here you can see that this is the output waveform at 470 pf. Now we will change the capacitor value. So firstly we have kept it at 470 pf, so this is the output waveform which we get at 470 pf. Now we will change the capacitor value. So let's keep it at 0.01 microfarad. Now let's keep it at 0.047 microfarad. So this is the waveform. Now we will keep it at 0.1 microfarad and now we will keep it at 1 microfarad. So this is the waveform which we get. You can observe the waveform by simultaneously changing the capacitor value. Similarly, you can check the waveform at 10 kHz frequency. So let's switch to 10 kHz. Then this is the output waveform at 10 kHz. And here we have kept capacitor value at 1 microfarad. Now we will reduce the capacitor value. So we have kept it at 0.1 microfarad. Now we will again reduce it to 0.047 microfarad. Now we will cap it at 0.001 microfarad and we will keep it at 470 pf. So this is the output waveform behavior when you change the capacitor value and you have changed the frequency also from 1 kHz and 10 kHz. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we will connect the square wave oscillator to the resistance 1k and the resistance other end is connected to the capacitor, and the other end of capacitor is connected to the ground. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit and we will switch on the DSO. So firstly we will observe the square wave from this square wave oscillator section. So here we have kept the square wave oscillator frequency at 10 kilohertz. So let's keep it at 1 kilohertz first. And now we will observe the output waveform. So we will connect it across C. So here you can see that we have taken resistance as 1K and we have kept the capacitor value at 470 pf, and this is the output we are getting. Now we will change the capacitor value. I have kept it at 0.01 microfarad. Now we will keep it at 0.047 microfarad. Now we will keep it at 0.1 microfarad, and now we will keep it at 1 microfarad. So this is the change in the waveform you can observe while changing the capacitor value. Now we will again keep the capacitor value at 470 pf, where we are getting the actual square wave. Now we will change the resistance value from 1k to 10k. So we will just change the connections from 1k resistance to 10k resistance. Now this is the waveform we are getting. Again we will change the capacitor value. So these are the changes you can observe on the waveform. Now we will provide 10 kilohertz frequency. Here you can see that this is the waveform we are getting. Here we can again change the capacitor value. So that is how you can observe the changes in the waveform while changing the capacitor value, the resistance value and the frequency. You can change the resistance value 1k or 10k, and you can change the frequency to 1 kilohertz or to 10 kilohertz, and you can change the capacitor value to 470 pf, 0.01 microfarad, 0.047 microfarad, 0.1 microfarad and 1 microfarad, and you can observe the output waveform behavior on the DSO. Now we will connect the square wave oscillator to one end of capacitor, and we will connect the other end of capacitor to the diode, and the other end of diode is connected to the ground of square wave oscillator. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit, and firstly we will observe the square wave at the square wave oscillator section. So we have kept the square wave frequency at 10 kilohertz. Let's keep it at 1 kilohertz first, like this. And now we will observe the output waveform. So this is the output waveform which we get at 470 pf capacitor value. Now we will change the capacitor value by rotating this port. So here you can see the changes in the waveform as we increase the capacitor value. So here the capacitor value is 1 microfarad, this is 0.1 microfarad, this is 0.04 microfarad, this is 0.01 microfarad, and this is 470 pf. So you can observe the waveform by changing the capacitor value, and you can change the frequency from 1 kilohertz to 10 kilohertz, like this. And here also you can change the capacitor value. So that is how you can observe the output. Now we will connect the square wave oscillator to the capacitor, and we will connect the other end of capacitor to one of the resistance. Let's take 1k resistance. Then we will connect the other end of 1k resistance to the diode. Then we will connect the other end of diode to the 1k resistance, and we will connect the other end of diode to the variable power supply, and we will connect the ground of the variable power supply to the ground of square wave oscillator like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit and we will observe the square wave oscillator input waveform. So here the frequency is 10 kilohertz. Now we will observe the output waveform. So here you can see that this is the output waveform at capacitor value 470 pf. So we will increase this capacitor value. So here I have kept it at 0.1 microfarad. Let's keep it at 1 microfarad, and we will give some variable power supply. Here you can see that when you will provide some voltage, this is the changes that occur in the waveform. So that is how this experiment is performed. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.